Hey everyone, it's Justin again. In the last video, we did a crash course in interval notation before learning how to find and write increasing and decreasing intervals of function graphs. In this video, we're going to be using that same notation to describe where function graphs are positive and negative. The good news is that the definitions this time are much easier to follow. A positive interval is the interval of inputs that will always result in a positive output, and a negative interval is the interval of inputs that always result in a negative output. It helps to know what you're looking for on a graph, and with positive and negative intervals, it couldn't be easier. Anything above the horizontal axis is positive, and anything below the horizontal axis is negative. Basically, all we're describing is whether the output is above or below zero. The only tricky part is remembering that any point where the output is exactly zero doesn't count as positive or negative. We leave those points out of both types of interval. So let's go ahead and do a few examples. Here's a basic linear function. You've seen these plenty of times throughout this course. Let's figure out on what intervals this function is positive and which intervals it's negative. If we start on the left side of the graph, we see that it starts out below zero. So this is a negative interval. How would we write it? The interval starts off the graph to the left, so we call that negative infinity. Where does the negative interval end? It ends where the function output hits zero, at an input of negative one. We can't use a square bracket here because negative one gives an output of zero, and we can't include that in the negative interval. After negative one, the function goes above the horizontal axis, so this would be a positive interval. The interval starts at negative 1 and ends way off the right side of the graph, so we say it goes from negative 1 to infinity, not including negative 1, since that output is 0, not a positive number. Remember, 0 isn't considered positive or negative, so any input that gives an output of 0 is excluded for both intervals, which is why both intervals in this example use a parenthesis for negative one instead of a bracket. What about this function? If we start on the left side, the first interval is below the horizontal axis, or negative. Because it starts off the graph and ends at negative one, we write that interval as between negative infinity and negative one. After that, the graph goes positive, then hits a maximum and starts coming back down. Still positive though, until it hits the horizontal axis again when the input is 5. So altogether, this positive interval started at negative 1 and ended at 5. That maximum was just a turning point. We don't need to factor it into the positive or negative intervals at all. Finally, after 5, we see that small portion that's back of the negatives. So we add a second negative interval starting at 5 and continuing forever to the right, or positive infinity. Just like with increasing and decreasing intervals, there may be several intervals that fit one or the other, in which case you can connect them with the union symbol. This next example is a hard one, but as long as we remember the basics, we're going to be fine. Pause the video now and see if you can figure out the positive and negative intervals on your own. Okay, let's see how you did. The first section of the graph we see is on a negative interval, from negative infinity to zero. Sometimes zero is treated like it's special, but this isn't one of those times. It's just another input on the horizontal axis. After zero, we see a positive interval. It starts at zero and it never goes back below the horizontal axis. So the interval is from zero to infinity, is what we would say if we didn't know any better. Remember what we said before, if the output is zero, we can't include it in a positive or negative interval. So we need to remove 3 from our positive interval by splitting it into two separate ones. The first interval is from 0 to 3, then the second interval is from 3 to infinity. By writing it this way, our interval essentially skips over 3 since it doesn't belong. Keep practicing. If you want a challenge, try drawing your own graph and writing positive and negative intervals. You could even throw in increasing and decreasing intervals. In the next video, we're going to finish studying graph characteristics by looking at functions that represent scenarios. See you then!